Violence against girls and women is as serious as it's ever been. 40% of women have experienced violence since the age of 15. It's a big problem that's not going away, and it's something that's going to take a big solution. We need to move beyond awareness campaigns and into strong-hearted, cool-headed violence prevention. So my name is Mel Thomas. I'm the founder of the Key Up Project. I'm a mother, a martial artist, and an advocate for kids living with domestic violence. I was born into family violence. My father was a classic abuser, so he cut us off from the rest of our family. Dad was really controlling. He was an alcoholic. He was a gambler. And he actually had like a really deep-seated mean streak, so he was really angry at life. I kept it to myself, and I definitely didn't talk about it at school. We hid it. I mean, I hid the bruises as best as I can, but he was also really good at not hitting us where it would be seen. I definitely used to worry that Dad was going to kill Mum and me and my sister. But mostly I just worried for my mum. There were incidents where, you know, the violence would get so bad that he would be so brutal that I didn't know how she'd cope with it. So I was about 13 when Mum finally left Dad. We didn't have any contact with him whatsoever so that she could keep us safe. When we left my dad, it was interesting that the violence that I was experiencing at home was sort of coming to an end, but then I was going through this violence and bullying at school. I'd been pushed around by my dad, and now here I was getting pushed around at school, and I couldn't see any other way out of it. I met these kids that were part of a gang, and they were really aggressive, and everyone was scared of them, and I thought, I want to be that person. I want to join this gang. I found myself becoming a bully, and everything that I didn't like about the people that had hurt me. I was just doing whatever it was that I could do to feel like I wasn't weak. The violence didn't stop, but it seemed to have come to a head when one of my first boyfriends beat me up and rearranged my face after the most minor disagreement. Because between my dad, his boyfriend, and the girls at school, I was at breaking point.
Mel was 19 when we first met. Mel had trust issues with not just myself, but with, you know, generally people.
Craig was different to all the other guys I'd ever gone out with because he didn't have a criminal record and his car wasn't stolen. He grew up in a beautiful, healthy, loving family. I like to say that he showed me what normal relationships look like.
So one of our first dates was, I actually took her to a martial art grading.
I was really excited about Hapkido because I could feel strong. I learned a way to defend myself, and it had never occurred to me that I could. We channel the other person's energy, and so that we can use their violence back towards them.
When you go to a martial arts class, you go as a blank canvas. It's not just physical, but it's spiritual as well.
Martial arts has been a huge part in my healing journey.
You know, I knew she was from a troubled past. It wasn't until we had kids that I actually realised how bad it was for her. You know, one particular moment where, you know, Mel was, she was dreaming about that she was drowning as a baby. She brought this up with her mother, and her mum said, "Well, you know, your father tried to drown you when you were, you know, when you were a kid." And it's things like that that sort of came to the surface after Chloe was born.
I looked at her and I couldn't believe that, you know, my father had been so violent towards a little baby. And I thought, I want her to have a different future, and she will.
Today, this is a judgment-free zone. Don't worry about judging yourself or judging each other.
And I thought, what if I could take my personal story of living with domestic violence and my specialist self-defense training and create something that would help end the cycle of violence against women and children. I asked them before, were you interested in martial arts? They're like, no. I applied to the Lane Beachley Aim for the Stars Foundation for a grant, and it was amazing because she said, you know, I believe in your idea, Mel.
People limit their capacity to even pursue a passion because they fear it. She experienced the shame and the suffering and the heartache that's associated with being a victim of domestic violence. And the fact that she wanted to do something about it is incredibly noble.
First of all, we're going to unlock our voice. Can I get an oh yeah? Oh
yeah! It comes down to people standing up for themselves and fighting for what they believe in. And Mel, through her Kite Project, is providing people with the tools and the skills and the lifeline to do that.
KIA Project is on a mission to create a nationwide army of ninjas. So KIA means to shout. It's a Korean word that we use in martial arts.
KIA!
It was really cool. Like, I just wanted to let it out.
Yes! As a woman, it feels good to yell. And...
if you don't know what makes you awesome, you don't know what makes you worth protecting. So I'm going to turn to the girls next to us, and we're all going to write something positive.
Sort of reminding everyone that they are worth something, no one's worthless, and it's sort of just a reminder for me friends that they're always there for you as well.
Step through underneath me, spin, shout, Kia!
I think it's really important that we have women teach girls and women self-defense, because most men haven't taken any precautions to stop themselves from being raped.
So when I add my body weight to it, see how I'm already out.
Girls are seen as weak, and we should be seen as powerful. If someone attacks me or anything like that, I'll know.
I am strong!
I am strong!
I am worth protecting!
From adversity comes greatness. And the fact that Mel has turned such fierce adversity into incredible empowerment and support for other people just shows how resilient and tenacious and courageous she is.
We need to support our kids, to give them the tools and the confidence to break the cycle of violence, because that's where it's going to come through again.
Kia!
Kia!
It's starting with my kids, your kids.